Hi friend, once again welcome to Turnaround Academy, and today's topic is Turnaround Premises. So thank you very much those who have subscribed, and those who have not subscribed, please subscribe and click the bell icon. You can send your comments also in the comment box, or you can write me info@ta-academy.com, so that I will respond to you. And whatever your requirement, I will try to make the new videos and present to you. So today's topic is turnaround premises, and let us start with that. Content of turnaround premises. What are the contents are showing here? I am going to explain in detail about all the content. So don't miss any of the content so that you will miss the sequence. Number one, what is turnaround premises? Who is responsible to prepare the turnaround premises? How to prepare the turnaround premises? What are the topic to be addressed while preparing the turnaround premises? One sample turnaround premises. So all these details I am going to explain throughout the video. So don't miss it. Those who has not yet subscribed, please subscribe my channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon. Now let us start. What is turnaround premises? The premises are analog to the basis of design documents for capital project. In that, the premises set out what management expects to achieve in return for the turnaround expenditure. Turnaround is huge budget requirements. You know, to conduct any turnaround, huge budget requirements. Maybe 30 million, 40 million, 50 million. If it is the, suppose the capacity of your train around 2.3 to 2.5 million ton per annum, such train capacity, if you want to do the turnaround, so budget requirement will be around $25 to $30 million. Okay, so this much amount management wanted to expend. So what they are expecting from this turnaround? Maybe management, they wanted to increase the production from 2.3 million to 2.5 million ton per annum of LNG. So like this, management, they are going to set up various objectives. The premises should clearly indicate the main objectives of the turnaround. So management will give you the clear objectives, why they wanted to do the turnaround and what is their expectation from this turnaround. So it depends on the various project basis. What is the expectation? So accordingly, you need to prepare the objectives of the turnaround. For example, management wants the annual production to increase from 2.3 million ton per annum LNG to 2.5 million ton per annum LNG. So management, they want some design improvement so that they can achieve this production. So like this, one of the objectives. Like this, there will be many objectives. It depends on the every projects, every turnaround. So accordingly, you need to prepare the objectives, and it need to be defined while preparing the turnaround premises. Okay, the actual premises are likely to be a short 1 or 2 page documents. Their preparation will require significant thought and discussion, and as such should not be taken lightly. To prepare the turnaround premises, you need the significant thought, and you need to study properly. So don't take this one as a lightly. This is the first milestone, and this will be the roadmap. So management, once they are preparing the turnaround premises, they are taking it very seriously. And keep in mind, while you are preparing the turnaround premises, don't make it very big. You need to prepare maximum 2 to 3 pages of this, and major milestone, major objectives, major policy decision, budget requirements, that you need to only incorporate it while preparing the turnaround premises. Now, what is turnaround premises? So what are the management expectation? All work that is proposed for the turnaround must be tested against the premises for compliance, and during the scope challenge exercise, the premises will be used extensively for this purpose. So that means while you are doing the scope challenge session, that time premises policy decision you need to consider. Okay, how to conduct the scope challenge, that is different subject, that I will make the separate video, you can go through this. So while you are preparing the scope challenge, so management has given the direction and policy decision in the turnaround premises, so you need to consider while doing the scope challenge. Since it is very important that there is site-wide awareness of the premises, they should be widely circulated and prominently posted with the appropriate commentary from the management. You need to make the awareness with the stakeholder about the premises. What is the policy decision has been taken by the management, that need to be communicated to the various stakeholder, so that they will be aware about the policy decision and they need to follow the key milestone. Since the premises will be used to define the scope of work, it is necessary that they be right first time, since changes to the premises after the planning is underway may require a second review or challenge or the proposed work. So you need to make a provision for the second review of the turnaround premises. Why? Turnaround premises in generally 18 months prior to the feed out date management is going to release. Okay, and that time you may have only 90% scope of work. So they are going to declare the budget for the turnaround and duration also. But while you go through the detailed planning and then you find out that with the help of this budget, you will be not able to deliver all the scope of work. You may need additional budget. Maybe the duration what they have given in the premises, that is not enough. So while you are doing the detailed planning, all these will be identified. So accordingly, you need to amend the turnaround premises. Now, who is responsible to prepare the turnaround premises and how to prepare it? In order to properly prepare for a major turnaround, it is important that the management prepare turnaround premises. So, management prepare turnaround premises. Who is management? Keep in mind, it will be above turnaround manager level. Somewhere it is said senior management, somewhere it is said corporate, somewhere it is said board. So it will be above the turnaround manager level. Okay. During this phase, management figure out an objectives for your turnaround. What I said, management will give you the objectives of the turnaround. What are the objectives in this turnaround? Okay, that also will be defined in the turnaround premises. A feasibility study need to be conducted to investigate whether each option addressed in the turnaround objectives and identifying the major deliverable for the project. Feasibility study, that is one of the important activity management need to carry out. There may be various options, you know. Suppose you have a project where you are going to change the cryogenic column, or maybe there is a heavy equipment replacements are there, or maybe there is an underground cooling water line to be replaced. Now there will be various options. You need to do the feasibility study. For example, let us take about the underground cooling water line you need to change during the turnaround. That was the scope of work has been given by the inspection team, because throughout the year it was noticed that there is a so many leakage. But is it feasible during the turnaround? Are you able to do the excavation where your other activity is there? Your crane movement will be restricted. There will be lot of water logging in that area. Hence, feasibility study need to be conducted to identify all these things, and accordingly what are the best option that need to be adopted to attain that particular scope of work during turnaround. this should be done along with the naming of turnaround manager and issuing the turnaround premises. So in the turnaround premises, management or senior management, they are going to declare the name of turnaround manager. You may have the question, what is the necessary? There is already turnaround manager. No, maybe you have two train. Okay, one train you have the shutdown, and after 2 months you have another train shutdown, and you have the limited resources. So if you give one manager to focus for the both turnaround, so he will be having too much workload, and maybe he will not be able to focus both in parallel. So suppose in your department you have one turnaround manager, and you have the turnaround back to back turnaround, today one turnaround, and after 2 months there is a one more turnaround, and one turnaround maybe you have the capacity of 10 million, and one turnaround maybe you have the capacity of 30 million. Okay, so now one turnaround manager, if you provide if you nominate one turnaround manager for both the turnaround, so you may have some issue. So what is the best practice management? Management is going to decide. Management will decide, okay, you have in your team maintenance engineer or maybe the team leader, the small budget turnaround, for example 10 million. So it can be policy decision. Okay, 10 million capacity turnaround can be done by the team leader. So management can decide, okay, team leader will be the turnaround manager for the turnaround where the budget is required 10 million. So he will focus on that. Okay, and where the bigger capacity budget is required, like a 30 million, 40 million, so you can nominate the another turnaround manager for that. So that is the reasons management need to decide the name of the turnaround manager while they are releasing the turnaround premises. The turnaround manager will be responsible and accountable for entire process from here onwards and shall report to the general manager or vice president. From here onwards, turnaround manager is responsible and accountable for all aspects of the turnaround, and he is going to report to the general manager or some cases vice president. I think you may now understand who is responsible to prepare the turnaround premises: senior management or management. Okay, he may be the general manager or vice president of the division. Topic address in the turnaround premises. And this is not all. You may add or delete or amend some of the topics based on your project requirement. So let us see what are the topic I am going to consider while preparing the turnaround premises. Okay, number one, date of turnaround. So what is the turnaround date? Number two, turnaround duration. So how long this turnaround will be? Okay, number three, turnaround cost and budget. So how much will be the cost, what will be the budget, that management is going to describe in the turnaround premises. Number four, QHSC performance. So management will decide this turnaround, our target is zero LTI. So like this, QHSC performance will be also measured during the turnaround. So that guideline also will be given in the turnaround premises. Number five, work scope development. Work scope development guideline also management will declare in the turnaround premises. So while you are preparing the scope of work, so you need to follow that guideline. Number six, policy of the items to be included in the scope. So management will give you the policy guideline, what are the item to be included in the turnaround scope. Number seven, scope freezing policy and date. So management will give you the guideline, scope freezing date, that will be the scope cutoff date, and what is that, that will be also included in the turnaround premises. Number eight, deadline for submission of work including project. So management will give the guideline for all the stakeholder, this is the cutoff date, this until this date you can include all the scope of work what is falling under this policy. Okay, number 9, policy of scope challenge. So what is the scope challenge policy? That also management will give the guideline in the turnaround premises. Number 10, scope challenge methodology. What are the methodology you need to follow while doing the scope challenge? That guideline also management will provide in the turnaround premises. Number 11, policy of new work request after cutoff date. So after cutoff date, what are the equipments or any work request need to be included in the turnaround? That policy guideline also need to be included in the turnaround premises. Number 12, desire pre-TA and post-TA length cycle. So management also provide you the guideline how long will be the pre-turnaround phase and how long will be the post-turnaround phase. So these all 12 items minimum you need to consider. You may amend or delete or add few more points as per the project requirements. So kindly watch the entire video, because all the activities there is a sequence. Okay, so you need to follow that sequence to understand, otherwise maybe you will not able to understand fully. So let us go ahead with the detail one by one. Okay, sample turnaround premises. Okay, so here I am going to explain you one sample turnaround premises so that you will be able to understand, to prepare, and you can take it as a guideline while you are preparing sample turnaround premises. So what you have to do, first you need train of the turnaround premises. So you have to write the header as a what are the unit or train you are planning for the turnaround. So that will be the header. Okay, then number 1, date of turnaround. So first what you have to write, this is the date of turnaround. In general, date of turnaround is actually long process. This will be as per 10 years or 5 years plan. Okay, so that is the date you have to capture here while preparing the turnaround premises. Number 2, turnaround timing and duration. So duration, what will be the duration for the turnaround and timing. Okay, so turnaround timing and duration. So this will be defined how long this turnaround. This is maybe 30 days, 40 days or 50 days, what is the requirements. Okay, so that duration will need to be defined here. Turnaround will be beginning with feed out on so and so date. So that means management will say this is the feed out date. That means in that day operation they will start cut off the productions. Okay, so feed out date. Keep in mind total outage is XY days duration. So XY means some days. Okay, maybe 20 days, 30 days, 40 days. That will be the total outage. This outage is including operation window. Operation also needs sometimes for shutting down the plant they need 7 days, and to for the startup they need around 7 days. So you, if you plan for 30 days, so 15 days will be allocated for operation, so you will be having only 15 days mechanical window. So that is the reason management is clearly given the guideline, operations you need to complete all your operation activity within this duration and mechanical activity these durations. Okay, so that's why it is very much important to define this duration in the premises. Turnaround budget will be also mentioned here. So management has given this much amount, you have to manage all the turnaround with this. So then that is the challenge of the turnaround manager. You have to go ahead and see the options where you can do the cost cutting. It's not very simple that you go and ask and they will increase. You have to prepare a lot of justifications and with the proper documentary evidence and planning and all the details, then only you can get it approved. And then you have to go back to the authority policy holder, senior management, that means GM or vice president. So this is the budget has been approved in the premises, but after reviewing this scope of work, I will be not able to deliver with this budget. Either I have to increase the budget, I have to increase the duration, or I have to cut the scope of work. Okay, so it is very, that is the challenge of the turnaround manager. It's not so easy. Okay, that I will not do this job, I will not able to do because I don't have the budget.
because there is a reliability departments are there. So nobody will leave you. So you have to be very careful. So that is the role of the turnaround manager, what is required to be done. Okay. So number four, QHSE, quality, health, safety and environment. What is that? What is the management expectation from that? Very important point. Management expectation from this, turnaround will be executed with a goal of no lost time incident. No lost time incident, LTI. Zero LTI, that is the management has been decided as a turnaround objective. So this is one of the key element for the turnaround premises, keep in mind. Environment will not be affected by the hydrocarbon draining or acid gas flaring. Very important point. Management wants, what is the management requirement? Once you are shutting down the plant, so many hydrocarbon you are going to drain it, but how you are going to control it? Management is very serious about that. So means it's not like this, anything you can drain. So before shutting down the plant or during the shutting down process, that is the management has given the direction that has to be followed, and flaring to be minimized. And if there is an indicator, what is the flaring, and this many days train will be shutting down, so remaining you may have two or three trains are there, so that sulfur recovery unit may be out of the turnaround, so flaring will increase, so many constraints will be there. So management has given the direction that minimize it, optimize it as much as possible. It's not like that. So you have to, as a turnaround manager, you have to take the precautions and details. Similarly, this is applicable for the operation also. So the point what is said, hydrocarbon drainage, okay? Hydrocarbon drainage to be minimized. It's not like this. Suppose if you have given the equipments for the spreading and huge sulfur has drained, that means you have not drained it. You have not properly drained it, and you have released the equipments for the mechanical window for the spreading. So this will go, who is responsible or accountable? There will be committee, they will decide, and then there will be corrective action. We will not discuss in this all detail. That is the management, they will decide. Okay. So that is the direction management has given. Everybody, all the stakeholder has to follow. Okay. Number five. Work scope development. That is very guideline. Management has given the very clear guideline how you are going to develop the scope of work. It's not like this, you know, nice to have work you have to include. Means any work is there, I decided maintenance, running maintenance or any other stakeholder, they decided, okay, after 6 months there is a shutdown, I will do it during the shutdown. No. Management wants only the job to be included in the turnaround which cannot be done during running plant. So any stakeholder is willing to come to add their scope in the turnaround, it is indicating their competency, their functional issue, and management take it very seriously, and they wanted to go ahead and try to find out what is the root cause, why this scope not yet attended during the routine maintenance and it has given to the turnaround. So this is very important. Items that require turnaround to restore unit to increase the unit train capacity from this million ton per annum. That means management said maybe you have some modification to be done to increase the capacity or maintain the capacity, that is the guideline will be given to the turnaround premises. So maybe your capacity is 2.3 million ton per annum, but last year you have not able to achieve. And why you have not able to achieve? Because last maintenance you have not changed so many equipments, or you have not replaced the so many spares while doing the overhauling of the equipments or control valves, and you have just reused the same existing spare. So what happened? You not able to maintain that 2.3 million ton per annum production. So management has given the guideline. This year guideline is 2.5 million. And so that our maintenance we have to do some upgradation may required, some whatever the things are required, that you have to do. Okay, tick list circulation date. This is tick list circulation date. What is tick list? Initially, when we are generating the scope of work, it will be in the maintenance planning, what you said in the SAP, you have defined all the tagged equipment, okay, and which are the equipment to be included in the turnaround. These all are defined in the tick list. It is a historical data. You just run the report and it will come, and there is an indicator, okay, XYZ in ABC indicator, we say there is an indicator, ABC indicator. So which is equipment are free means it is giving the indication anytime can be done, you should not include it. There will be indicator T, tied, means this equipment can be released if other equipment is released related to each other. And another is what I said, tie T F ABC indicator, that is one is free. If it is indicating the F, that means it is free. So anytime that equipment can be released and you can take it, then T, it is tied, it is related to other equipment. If other equipment is released, this equipment can be released. And another is it cannot be released. So anytime you cannot do this job. Number 5, work scope development. Okay, this is also one of the items to be included in the turnaround premises. What is that work scope development? Items that require turnaround to restore unit, to increase the unit or train capacity, some millions ton per annum. So what is that? Items that require turnaround to restore unit, to increase the unit or train capacity, some millions tons per annum. Okay, maybe 30 million ton, the capacity is 2.3 million ton per annum. So management had decided we will do certain modifications and so that production can be increased from 2.3 million ton per annum to 2.5 million ton per annum. Okay, so that may be one of the items is there, so that some modification may include in the scope. Number 2, tick list circulation date. What will be the date of circulation of the tick list? Now what is tick list? These all are in detail, you know, it is a different scope. I will make one separate video where I will explain, but in short I just tell you, when once the scope is generating, scope of work is generating, that time the first job is tick list to be circulated. Every department they have the SAP. Okay, in the SAP all these work order or equipment stacked has been defined a ABC indicator. Okay, now what is ABC indicator? In short, just I will brief you. ABC indicator, it will tell you some of the equipments they have code, they have assigned the code ABC indicator as a F. F means free. Free means it can be released anytime, so it will not be included in the turnaround. Some is mentioned T. T means it's tied with some other equipment. So if one equipment is released, then that only this can be released. So it will also not be a part of turnaround. And some of the equipment it is mentioned V. V means vital, means this equipment cannot be released. So it can be only done during turnaround. So you have to run the report and only the indicator, ABC indicator in the SAP is showing V, that only need to be included in the scope of work. So like this, you have to circulate the tick list and it will go to the all the stakeholder and everybody will give the comments on that. For example, the operation, they will write, okay, some of the equipment, they have some operational issue, so they want to open and they want to inspect. Inspection, they will, corrosion point of view, integrated point of view, they will assign, okay, I wanted to do the NDT of the certain equipments, I wanted to open all the trays, tray manuals of the column and wanted to go inside to inspect. Like this, every stakeholder, process engineer, they wanted to change the catalyst. Like this, every stakeholder will give some comments and that will be captured, and after that the provisional work list will be released. then comments received date from the stakeholder. Now, once you circulate the tick list, everybody has to give the specific comments on the day. So here the management in the turnaround premises, they have deciding this is the dates, whoever who is wanted to include the scope in the turnaround, they have to give the comments. Because as I told you, the initial list will be how? It will be the tick list, where only we are going to take only the vital what is mentioned. That means the equipment cannot be released anytime. That only will be included. So what I said, even some of the equipments may be free, but maintenance, when they approach to the operation to release the permit to attend that equipment, operation unable to release because the isolation valve is passing. So they cannot put the mechanical blind on that to isolate the equipment because valve is passing and plant is running. So that equipment will be converted into the turnaround. So that means maintenance engineer as a stakeholder, he has to write on that equipment to be included in the turnaround. So that comments, it will come there. So what is the comments received date from the stakeholder? So that means every stakeholder is very important and they have to give the comments in the specific date, and there will be no change on the date, so that rightly scope of work can be developed and final work list can be released. Provisional work list to release, provisional work list release date. Provisional work list release date. Now, all these comments, once it will come, the provisional work list has to be captured, prepared, and that has to be released for the scope challenge. So there will be date will be mentioned in the premises. Okay, this is the date. In this date, planning engineer has to release the provisional work list. Okay, so that has to be followed. Then scope challenge date, that also will be mentioned there. What is the scope challenge date? So in that date, scope challenge to be done an effective way, but I'm not going in detail, just to I'm touching the subject to understand, but I'm not going in detail. I will make in the separate video for the scope challenge, scope preparation and all these details. You can watch on that if you have it's not clear to you. Then final work list. So this is the date we have to release the final work list. So what I said, scope, work scope development, work scope development, that is to be defined in the premises, and there is a key dates, very important. That is the most important thing management has to declare, and so that all the stakeholder has to follow this date, so that you will get all the comments in time and you can issue the final work list in time. Okay. Number 6, policy of items to be included in the turnaround. Policy of items to be included in the turnaround. Now management will give you the guideline. Okay. What is policy to be followed once you are adding any scope of work in the turnaround? Here it is, work list acceptance will be frozen on Saturday and so date. Okay, so work list will be frozen in this date. So this is the cutoff date management have given. So within this date, we have to finish, and additional work will be challenged and approved by the turnaround manager. What the management is saying, after that additional work, if anything is there, turnaround manager with his team, he will challenge the scope of work and he will decide it has to be included or excluded. Work scope should be submitted with the assumption that in most case, work that can be done while the unit is operation will not be considered, unless there is a substantial economical, safety or environmental benefits to complete during the turnaround. This is very important. It's not like this, you know, the cutoff date has gone and so it will not be a part of turnaround. No, you have to do the cost benefit analysis. So that is the reason he say work scope should be submitted with the assumption that in most case, work that can be done while the unit is operational will not be considered. So most of the cases it is not going to consider, because anytime job you have to do anytime, unless there is a specific reason. But even that it is anytime job, but such bigger job where there is a huge budget impact, there is a safety issue is there, maybe you need to have the specialized contractor for this SPMT, maybe 250 ton crane, maybe 300 ton crane, so which the beyond capacity of the maintenance daily day-to-day maintenance team. So that you need to, even it is a anytime job, you have to consider in the turnaround. That is the philosophy or guideline management has given, and turnaround manager, he has to follow this. Next topic is scope freezing policy and date. That is very important. What is the scope freezing date and what will be the policy? That is the management is giving the guidelines, okay, that everybody have to follow. That means all the stakeholder, they have to respect and honor these dates. Every major turnaround must have a clearly defined scope covering 90% of the total at least 18 months prior to the start date. This scope should be frozen at least 9 months prior to the start of the turnaround. At the same time, a firm duration estimate and the initial critical path are determined. So that means a firm decision has been taken. This is the duration of the shutdown and this is the critical path. So 90% scope, what is included, that management has given the direction. However, as I told earlier, there will be second review. So if there is something is missing or something cannot be incorporated in terms of duration or budget, that will come in the second review. Okay, but initially management will give the direction. If scope creep happen on the turnaround, it will result in the increased time, cost, resources and potential reduced quality and thus increased risk of turnaround deliverable. This is very important. What is scope creep? That I will explain in the separate video, but in short I will tell you, if there is a changes in the scope happen frequently, the planning deliverable is there. You have to prepare, you have to reserve the material, you have to prepare the resource requirement, you have to prepare the quality point of view, HFC point of view, many things are there. That is in the detailed planning milestone it will come. So if the scope you are not able to freeze, so how you are going to deliver? You will compromise with the quality of the deliverable. You did not plan properly, you did not consider the resource properly, your workbook is not ready, because frequently you are changing the scope. That is the reason it is very clearly that the date is very important, need to be defined, and all the scope of work need to be freeze accordingly. Okay, ideally the approving authority should be the turnaround manager, but if work required significantly will impact on the material availability, schedule change or add more cost, then the policy team approval is required. Very important. If any additional scope afterwards need to be included in the scope for whatsoever the reason, turnaround manager will validate with his team first. But once during the validation, if he find out there is a cost impact, there is a schedule impact, material may not be available, he will ask the senior management approval for this, or to cancel this job or postpone this job from the turnaround. So here this is very important, and that everybody has to honor. So scope freeze is very important, or everybody need to honor this date and policy so that such thing can be avoided. Cut-off date for the scope inclusion in date and month. Okay, the cut-off date, that is very important. Here the management will say this is the cut-off date, after that no scope will be considered for the turnaround unless until there will be separate definition for that if it is falling under that. Okay, so cut-off date also management will decide, this is the cut-off date for the scope freezing. Okay, number 8, deadlines for submission of work. What will be the deadline for any work submission for inclusion? This is normal one. Okay, it is not a additional work. That means this is the dates you can include your scope of work in normal way, so that turnaround manager is responsible to make sure the material availability, resource availability to address that job. So management will decide for the cut-off date. So deadline for submission of the work. So accordingly you have to plan. Number 9, policy on scope challenge. So management has given the very clear direction. During the scope challenge, it's not like this, you do as per you wish. No. Management has given the very clear policy direction, what are the scope to be included or excluded while you are challenging the scope of work. What is that? Work that is necessary to be ensure the integrity, operability, reliability and efficiency of the unit and which cannot be carried out safely or cost effectively during operation will be included in the turnaround. So it is very clear. Management has very clearly given the direction. If it is the integrity issue, if it is the cost issue, risk issue, all these issues, even it is free, you have to include in the turnaround so that can be taken care. Okay, so that is very important. Work justified when? Now in this policy, they have given further justifications. How you are going to challenge the scope of work? Okay, they have given the guidance. So management has given the further direction. What is that? Number A, it established or validates the technical or integrity of the equipment or system, including meeting saturated requirement. So it is the question of the integrity. So you have to include that. Okay, so that is the direction management they have given in the turnaround premises. Number B, it restore the operability and or reliability of the unit system to the desired level. So they are telling it is restoring the operability or the reliability of the unit system to the desired level. You have to consider if it is falling under that in the scope of work. It restore the operational efficiency to desired values. Operational efficiency, very important. You have to consider to include in the scope. It provides data which will help reduce work volume in future turnaround and or extend inspection interval. If some scope, if you include, so in or modification you are incorporated, so inspection interval will increase, maybe after 4 years or 8 years, you need to consider. So that means management is giving the direction to you, what you need to include or what you need to exclude. E, it enables the execution or approve projects and plan changes which cannot be otherwise be implemented, which cannot be implemented in during a running plan or otherwise, that you have to consider. So management is given the very clear direction so that you should not remove everything from the scope. No, this is not there, that is not there. No, management is given the clear direction what is to be included and what is to be excluded. That is very important. Okay, number 10, scope challenge methodology. What is the scope challenge methodology you have to adopt while you are including the scope of work or challenging the scope of work? Okay, so management has given the flow diagrams, through that you will be able to understand, okay, this is to be followed. What is that? Scope challenge methodology, work list, risk assessment methodology, historical data and facts. These all will come together, risk of not doing the activity at all. Now, if you follow this methodology, what will happen? What is the risk? If with this exercise, if you find out it is high or it is low, if it is low, what is going to happen? It will be out of the scope. No, very low risk. If something happen, it is cooling water line or something, so you can do it anytime. So that will be excluded. If it is high, we have to do the job. But what is it? If it is high, can be postponed till next year? You have to see. If it is possible to postpone it for the next year because many reasons, maybe you don't have the budget, maybe your time is not permitting for the turnaround to include it, or maybe material will not be available. So many reasons, you have to see what are the reasons are there. Okay, so accordingly you decide. So you can postpone or not. If it is no, it will be in the scope. So this is the methodology, a simple methodology. Management has given the guidance you need to follow. I just summarize it: work list, risk assessment, historical data and facts. So whatever in the work list is there, risk assessment methodology you have to follow, and you have to review the historical data, is this equipment is having issue or not, and then you have to do the risk assessment. If it is low risk, you can simply it is take it out from the scope and do it in the later on. And if it is a high risk, you have to decide can be included in this turnaround or it can be postponed. There will be various reasons. Maybe you need the more resources which has not possible to mobilize in this stage when this scope has been identified, or maybe you are out of budget, you don't have the budget to do the job, maybe you don't have the schedule to include that job, maybe you don't have the material to attend this job. So accordingly you have to decide. So accordingly this is the methodology management has given to be followed. Okay, so this is scope challenge methodology. Number 11, policy on new work request after cutoff date. So here the management is giving the guidance what are the policy to be followed to include any scope of work after cutoff date. What is that? What is the guideline management has given? Let us see. Once the work list is frozen, changes to the scope prior to the turnaround can only be made upon approval from the turnaround manager. So what is saying? Turnaround manager can take a decision. Okay, and how to take a decision, that also management is saying. The team shall review all new items on a monthly basis. The team shall review all the new items monthly basis. So means every month planning team has to sit with the turnaround manager with the proper justifications. These are the items has been requested by various stakeholder and that is required to be included or excluded. Accordingly, turnaround manager will take a decision. Okay, what is next? The approving authority will be the turnaround manager, but if work request significantly will impact on the material availability, schedule change or and more cost, then the policy team approval is required. It is very clear guideline management has given. What is that? Once again I repeat, the approving authority will be the turnaround manager, but if work request significantly will impact on the material availability, schedule change or add more cost, then the policy team approval is required. So means every month turnaround manager, what he will see, what are the additional scope has been requested, he has to review with the team. What is the material impact? Maybe material will not available. What is the cost impact? Maybe there will be minor cost impact, or maybe there is schedule impact or additional resource required or budget required or not. So if it is the minor, he may approve. If it is the major impact, then he will approach to the senior management. So accordingly, management guideline, additional budgets or maybe extension, schedule extension, all this if it is approved, it will be included or it will be excluded. Okay. Any additional unanticipated work requested during the turnaround for this equipment will be considered as emergent work and shall be treated as new work request. This is during turnaround. So they have given also guidelines, some of the emergent work which was not anticipated earlier, but during the turnaround it has been identified. So that will be considered as a additional work request. Okay. And that also there will be also same risk assessment methodology we have to follow. Maybe if the material available, you will do. If it is not available, what you are going to do? If your schedule is not permitting on that, so how you are going to box up the equipment without attending this job? What will be the consequence? So risk assessment methodology to follow, and accordingly you have to take action. I'll just simple example in short I will tell you. For example, some material is not available, but what you did, now you repair the equipments and order the material, and this material availability may be 6 months. So what will happen, this work request will convert it to the maintenance, to the maintenance activity. So once the material will arrive, and if there is any opportunity in future is coming, that time the maintenance will do the job. So that is the reasons that risk assessment methodology we need to follow. Okay. Number 12, desire pre-TA and post-TA cycle length. That is also very important. This is also very important. Management has given the clear direction when you are going to start the pre-turnaround activity. Okay. What is that? Pre-turnaround activity to be carried out 6 to 8 weeks prior to the shutting down the units. So management is giving the direction to all the stakeholders 6 to 8 weeks before the pre-turnaround activity to be carried out. I am not going to discuss here in detail what are the pre-turnaround activity. Here the point is, he is giving the direction to the stakeholder, especially to the operation. You should be prepared with your team to release the request, whatever the request is given by the turnaround manager, like a scaffolding erections or some other preparation preparatory activity, they have to allow. So 6 to 8 weeks before the turnaround. So policy decision has been taken from the senior management level. So that here the stakeholder is operation, they have to follow the, and also turnaround manager, he has to also request accordingly. So that means what here? Number 12, desire pre-TA and post-TA cycle length. This is also very important. Here the management is giving the clear direction what will be the duration and when you are going to start the pre-turnaround and post-turnaround activities, what will be the length of that. That is going to be decided by the also management in the premises. Okay. What is that? Pre-turnaround activity to be carried out 6 to 8 weeks prior to the shutting down the unit. Here the management is giving the direction 6 to 8 weeks before of the turnaround, you have to start the pre-turnaround activity. What is that? Many activities are there. I am not going to discuss in detail. But for example, the scaffolding. So that means the stakeholder should release that permit accordingly. Who will be the stakeholder here? For example, the operation. They have to allow the turnaround manager to start the scaffolding erection 2 months before, or 6 weeks before, or 8 weeks before, or it depends on the volume of work you are having. Okay. So that means management is giving the direction to the stakeholder, you need to follow this. So no, there will be no argument or question. They have to release accordingly permit, okay, to start the job. Post turnaround activity to be carried out 4 to 6 weeks after start out of the unit. Here also management is giving the guideline. Within 4 to 6 weeks, all the post turnaround activity to be completed. So management is giving the direction to the turnaround manager and all the stakeholder, within 4 to 6 weeks, that means 1 month or 1.5 months, you have to complete everything. That means whatever the scaffolding we have erected, we have to remove. Whatever the insulation is not completed, that has to be completed. What are the other facility you have made for temporarily for turnaround, everything has to be clear. And there will be audit to be carried out so that the way the asset or plant was handed over for the turnaround, the same way turnaround manager returned the plant to the asset owner. Okay. So this is the overall turnaround premises. Okay. If you have any question, you can write to me. You can write your comments in the comment box, and also you can write to me info@ta-academy.com. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and share and click like buttons, and also click bell icons so that next video you are going to, once it is released, you are going to notify. This turnaround premises mainly for client side. However, the contractor side also, you need to know all these details so that you will having the very clear idea. So next topic will be, what is turnaround charter, how to prepare it, and what are the content to be included in the turnaround charter, what is the importance of the turnaround charter, that I am going to explain in detail, and that is for contractor turnaround manager and contractor turnaround management. But this is, as we said, it is a common goal, either it is contractor or client, both turnaround manager aligns, and they need to understand each and other responsibility. See you next turnaround chatter.